UN Secretary General, and welcome to the U Thant Show. We'll be discussing and attempting to resolve the ongoing human missile crisis, which greatly saddens me and destroys my hopes for a peaceful world.
No missile crisis!
Now, today, however, we have a few special guests to join us. Representing the Soviet Union, Premier Nikita Khrushchev. And next up from Cuba, we have Prime Minister Fidel Castro. Since the Cuban Missile Crisis centers around Cuba, allow me to ask Prime Minister Castro on how the past few days have been like.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for this opportunity. Right, let me put it this way, alright? The brink, United States Navy, the ship, it's around Cuba. The big, big battleship, okay? Nobody can come out of Cuba.
What a nightmare.
Yeah, no help. It is a big nightmare. Why? Because one day, just one day, right? The American, the imperialists, they'll come marching into my country, They'll attack my country. But it won't happen. It will not happen. I tell you why.
Tell them why.
Because. Because I'm my comrade, comrade Khrushchev.
He is good friend.
Yes. Yes, he's good friend, He gave me the gun. He give me the tank.
Give you the troops.
Yeah, he give me the troops, And he give me the missile. And the missile is a deterrent, And this deterrence, it protects the sovereignty and the freedom of the Cuban people. Right?
I see it first.
So together, we protect my country from imperialist ambition.
It's big dog.
Yeah, big dog. Yeah?
Big dog.
Yes?
Resentful, I see, Mr. Castro.
Very resentful.
What do you have to say?
This is absolutely preposterous. I'm simply trying to protect my people from the threat of nuclear devastation by the hands of the Russians and their destabilizing presence in Central America. I firmly believe it is my absolute duty and right to protect my people.
Hypocritical President Kennedy is very. What happened to the Turkish missiles? He put the missiles in Turkey and Italy. When I try to protect my people, all this fuss is created. But when he tries to protect this, is there any noise? Is there any noise? No! These are clearly the double standards of the US and the President Kennedy. And this UN, man, let's not forget this UN. Now, this UN is useless. They are subservient to the needs of the USA and this President Kennedy. You know I have a right to protect my fellow comrades in Cuba?
Premier,
go time.
It is obvious to the free world that the Soviet Union does not seek to really protect themselves from our
look at the lies
imperialism. They want to stir things up here and destabilize the whole political situation. Let me give you an example. We just emerged from the Berlin crisis.
Which you started.
No. Listen, listen. That clearly isn't the case. They built the Berlin Wall in order to prevent innocent East Germans from running away and escaping from their oppressive regime. And now they want to distract the entire world from this embarrassment of theirs.
You are the embarrassment. My God!
And so I was saying, my missiles in Turkey are there purely for defense. May I continue? Now, what was I saying? Yes, they are there. The Turkish missiles are there to protect my European allies.
At least I have friends, not puppets like you.
You have continually threatened the freedom and democracy in Europe. You are responsible for the escalation of Cold War tensions. And if you genuinely want to put an end to this conflict, you have to remove the Cuban missiles first.
You remove the Turkish missiles!
No, you remove the missiles first!
No, you!
No, I won't! And that is final!
It's very funny, huh? like kindergarten, like that.
Thank you, Secretary General U Thant, and I realize my mic is off.
Thank you, Secretary General U Thant, and welcome to the Voice of the People segment of the U Thant Show. That's right, people, it's your chance to ask our distinguished guests any question you guys want. So, without further ado, volunteer.
Does
that
have any
quest? Ah, yes, you, graceful number one. It's time for you to have some fun. Alright, before you ask the question, please state your name, your class, and the question you want to ask, huh?
I'm Eugene from T5, 105. And my question is to you, Prime Minister Fidel Castro. It appears that the superpowers are using Cuba, to further their own national interests. Don't you agree?
What is this nonsense? Who sent you?
Nicola!
Sit down!
I'm not rocky, I'm not puppet, alright? This
no,
is true friend.
True friend, yeah.
This is true friend. Only true friend will
sorry,
determine my hour of need,
yes,
right?
Yes,
right?
Yes.
Only true friend will give me gun. Only true friend will give me tank and missile, right?
Truth. Don't forget the truth.
Yeah,
don't.
The truth. This is true friend, right? He come help me, when my country under attack. He come help me so that we can stand together against the American imperialism in Latin America.
Yes, this imperialist bitch.
Stupid question, next time think some more,
Thank you, Eugene, and very sorry about that. Well, thank you. Next up, can we have the next question, please? Any volunteers, guys? Alright, Rachel number two. Alright, unfortunately, due to technical issues, my mic can't go there, so you have to project your voice. So this is the chance for you to project your voice.
Okay, I'm
Wayne from 1T03. My question is directed to Secretary General U Thant. Mr. U Thant, can I have your number? To my proper question, I find the UN very useless and ineffective in what it does. So now my question is, I question the purpose of the UN. Thank you.
It's a good question.
Certainly not Wayne Chan from 1T03. Now the United Nations...
Precisely, Mr. U Thant. I am outraged that you have yet to deal with the American aggressor, the peacock sitting opposite you.
The United Nations...
Aggressor? What aggressor? It is obvious that the USSR and Cuba are the aggressors in this situation.
Useless, utter rubbish.
Gentlemen, please. This is a talk show. You cannot talk so loud either. Now, as I was saying, the United Nations has considered...
And I have been negotiating directly and secretly, and never through the UN.
You negotiate without me.
Shut up, Chris.
You negotiate without me.
Sit down.
I'm utterly.
You see, it's useless time. He's utterly weak.
How you dare criticize the UN?
And Bessie can burn. It's utter dismay.
You negotiate.
Who are you to criticize the UN?
You started a crisis.
No,
who said something to who? It's me or you? Yeah, you know what? It's not something
I see. Ladies and gentlemen, especially our distinguished... Alright, we had our third and final speaker for today, and he comes straight from the Vatican. He is none other than Pope John the 23rd.
Haram citizen.
Thank you, Your Eminence, and that concludes the end of the Voice of the People segment of the U Thant Show. Well, back to you, Mr. U Thant.
Thank you, Pedro. And once again, thank you, Your Eminence, for gracing us with your presence. Gentlemen, do you have anything else to add? Mr. Christian. Castro. I find that the balance of this world is at stake. This silence is very alarming.
Mr. Kennedy, now, since the Pope has spoken, and since we're clearly getting nowhere from this useless arguing, it's incessant, it's driving me mad. You remove the Turkish missiles and remove the naval blockade over my Cuba here. Yes. And in return, I will remove the Cuban missiles. It's a win-win, don't you think? Yeah? Yes?
No, Premier Khrushchev. You are the aggressor here in this situation. You have to remove the Cuban missiles. If not, there will be no peaceful end to this conflict.
You promised to protect my country, now you remove the missiles.
Shut up, Khrushchev! Stop throwing a tantrum! Sit down now! No! Your sovereignty is of utmost importance. Let me negotiate direct privately with President Kennedy. Pro-Cuba will be safe. Please, listen to me. Enough with your cigarette. This is nonsense. Now, where were we? You remove the naval blockade. And in turn, I will remove the Cuban missile.
The missiles will stay.
Shut up! Goodness! Throw you to the gulags! Now, but in return, you promise never to set foot on Cuban soil. Doesn't that sound fair?
Okay, fair enough. Well, I guess that's it then.
Wait! What about the Turkish missiles? Have you not forgotten about your Turkish missiles?
Okay, I have an idea. I'll remove the blockade, and in return, you remove the Cuban missiles. And in a few months' time, secretly, I will remove the Turkish missiles. The elections are coming up back at home, and I promised my people security. And that is exactly what they will get.
What? Shut up! What about me? I need to show the world that USSR was strong. I need to show the world that I was there for Cuba. This stupid... This stupid Chinese. Yes, this stupid, ignorant Chinese claims USSR was a paper tiger. This is not true. We are strong people. The Soviets have been strong for a long, long time, and it will remain so. I need to show the world.
I'm afraid we're running out of time, but please take your seat. Mr. Khrushchev, since the Turkish missiles will be removed anyway, why not just take it?
Alright, that is the case. So be it. The missiles will go.
Well, Mr. Khrushchev, I guess this marks the beginning of the end of the Cold War.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I guess that brings us a close to this week's episode of the U Thant Show with the resolution of the Cuban Missile Crisis. We hope that you can join us in next week's episode of the U Thant Show.
Stop the music! Stop the stupid music now! Enough with this peace, alright? Look at the United Nations. Look at the
supposed to stop you, right?
You use the superpower.
You use the United. Stupid idiot.
When the superpower wants it, the United Nations go back to the superpower, right? They abandon Taiwan. They abandon Cuba. They abandon Turkey. They abandon all of you. You. They abandon the world. It is so.
Cuba has been found out by their Soviet friends, but their national security has been guaranteed. President Kennedy is now a popular man for appearing so cool-headed and cunning. Scandy, you have yet to remove the secret missiles, though.
Indeed. I do have to remove the Turkish missiles. Mr. Khrushchev over there thinks he has won, but his people won't even know that the Turkish missiles are being removed. He has been completely humiliated. Not only that, the Turkish missiles don't mean anything to me anyway.
Wait, why?
Why?
They're completely outdated and useless. What matters most to me now is that I've got plenty of submarines that are more than capable of replacing the Turkish missiles.
Well played, Mr. Kennedy. Well, why do you know, ladies and gentlemen? I guess the Cold War continues. Thank you everyone for coming down today. But now, let's have a curtain call. M. Kennedy, we have Santino Shepard! Starring as U Thant.
We have daddy shoes! And last but not least, sorry as Prime Minister of Israel has spoken, we have John Howden! Not forgetting the protest! Mr. Richard.